It's Friday afternoon, and that means it's time for questions and answers. We have one we're going to look at that comes from Matthew chapter 7, which very famously opens with Jesus' rebuke that we should not judge, lest we be judged. And the question is, concerns how that question is, or how that statement is often taken out of context. And so the question is just simply, can you put that verse back in its context so that we can use the expression correctly? It is often said if you tell someone that they're wrong in today's society, that they will look at you and they'll say, you're judging me, you can't judge me, Jesus says not to judge me. Well, Jesus didn't say I can't tell someone that they're wrong. If they are wrong, I'm supposed to tell them that they're wrong because my desire is for them to get right and to be right with God. But it's a funny statement for someone to make when they say, it is always wrong, you are wrong for telling me that I'm wrong. So if it's wrong to say that they're wrong, then aren't you wrong for telling me I'm wrong for saying you're wrong? You see how hypocritical and how not well thought out that idea is? But Jesus doesn't say, don't go around telling someone that they're wrong. Jesus says, don't judge lest you be judged. And then he explains that. So let's not just read the statement. Let's read Jesus' explanation of the statement as well. But the text begins in Matthew 7, verse 1. Judge not that ye be not judged. For with what judgment ye judge, you shall be judged. And with what measure you meet, it shall be measured to you again. What does that mean? That means if you try to judge someone, be careful, because the standard you use to judge them will be the standard used against you. And from that, Jesus continues, verse 3. And why beholdest thou the mote, the speck of sawdust, that is in your brother's eye, and consider not the beam, the 2x4? That is in thine own eye? Or how wilt thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote out of thine eye, and behold, a beam is in thine eye? Thou hypocrite, first cast out the beam that is in thine own eye, and then thou shalt see more clearly to cast the mote out of thy brother's eye. You notice that Jesus, as he lays out an illustration of judging, it is telling someone they have a mote in their eye. That's what he calls judging in the text. He ends the text by saying, ... so that you can tell them they have a mote in their eye. So Jesus does not condemn what the world calls judging. Jesus condemns judging by my standard, you judging by your standard. If I tell you you're wrong because I think you're wrong, that's wrong. If I tell you you're wrong because I want you to be wrong or because my opinion is that you're wrong, that's what's wrong. But if I tell someone they're wrong because the Word of God has said so, that's not just not wrong, that's 100% right and commanded. I'm supposed to do that. I'm supposed to tell people that is not what Jesus says to do. That is not what God says that we're allowed to do. That is not what your Bible authorizes you to do. You are forbidden to do that according to God. And I say that not to look down on someone. I will tell someone that not to make them feel bad about themselves, but to try to reach them so that they will stop doing what is wrong and start doing what is right. But I am condemned here if I tell someone you're wrong based on my opinion. That's not right. That's the illustration he gives. Because I try to judge you based on the standard of myself as though I am always right. Well, that kind of hypocritical attitude will expose itself as wrong because I'm trying to get a speck of sawdust out of your eye when I've got a 2x4 sticking out of my face. Jesus says, stop being such a hypocrite. Take the 2x4 out of your face and then you can tell someone that they have a mote, a speck of dust in their eye. How do I do that? If I live by the Word, I can tell someone else how to live by the Word. In other words, don't go judging someone if you yourself are not living the life properly. Does that mean I can't tell someone not to curse if I have ever said a curse word in my past? Yes, of course I can tell someone not to curse because the Word of God said so. But if I wasn't going by the Word of God, if I just went around telling people you can't say this and you can't say that as though I'm the standard, then I'm wrong because I myself might have made that mistake. The Word of God is perfect, not me. So I should not be the one judging people. I should let the Word of God do that, and I should just be the messenger boy. Along those same lines is a text, a statement by Paul in 1 Corinthians 4, verse 5, where he tells the brethren, don't judge anything before the time. Well, what does that mean? Look at verse 4 of 1 Corinthians 4. I know nothing by myself, Paul says. I am not me by me. I'm me by the grace of God. Yet I am not hereby justified, but it is the Lord who is the judge. God judges me. I don't judge me. I don't decide whether I'm right or wrong. God does. So he tells his brethren, don't judge me. Let God judge me at the final judgment. So we are not to be the deciders of who is right and wrong. God is. But before the judgment, it is our job as Christians to tell people to get right with God. And the only way you can tell someone to get right is sometimes to tell them how they're wrong so they'll know what not to do. So don't let people misuse this verse and tell you that you can't tell them not to wear that, or you can't tell them not to say that, or you can't tell them not to go there, or you can't tell them not to be with that person or what have you because they say that's judging. No, God has judged them. God has said that is wrong according to His word. You go be the messenger that tells them what God has determined is right or wrong. Hope that helps. Thank you for the question. We'll consider another one next week on Friday. Until then, thank you very much.